That you actually don't get to choose the job that you end up with. I think the job chooses you. I don't remember being like a young girl and thinking, oh, when I grow up, I'm going to be a model agency of plus size models. And it's a process. I think you, with the previous jobs that I'd had, I'd learnt certain things. I was a sales rep, so I knew how to meet and greet people, and I loved doing that. So that was part of the job. I loved traveling, which is part of what I do now. So when I look back over the career and where I've come, I think, well, no, I got to do now what I really love doing, which is obviously running the plus size modeling agency. Nobody did it. Nobody was on the catwalk as anybody over a size 12 to 14. And so I thought, well, someone has to do it. So I approached an agency and they said, sure, let's have a go. So I loved it. I was involved with lots of fashion parades, and I did, I was sort of like the token gesture girl, the big girl, get out there, big girl, and don't be out there too long. But what I found was the audience loved it because I was the only body shape they could really actually relate to. And they'd come, little ladies had come backstage and go, oh, Darianne, thank you so much. You were fabulous and we love what you had on. It's so good to see. The process of being a model was something I did for 10 years. Loved it. I actually, you know, in the middle of raising three children. And then when I turned 40, I went, okay, well, I'm not getting the bookings like I used to, so what am I going to do? And that's when the thought and a few other things came into play as to, well, I need to open up my own plus size modeling agency, because the trends were happening, the fashion was changing, but model agencies and the advertising agencies weren't keen to be, you know, have bigger girls seen. And basically that's how it all started. So when I turned 40, I opened up the agency, and 15 years later, I'm still here and loving it. I can honestly say that I am the first standalone plus size modeling agency, and actually I think in the world. I know I was the first here in Australia, and of course there are other plus size divisions within other agencies such as Ford Models in New York, Wilhelmina in New York, and Click, etc. But I am the standalone first ever agency. There are others now that have followed, but I mean, it's like anything else in the world. You only remember who comes first. You don't really remember who came second. So yeah, and your point about the plus size industry, yes, that's the changes that have happened. Now that editors are responding to consumer demand about seeing real women in magazines. So every day we get editors calling and emailing going, Darianne, we're doing a shoot for Real Women. Can you send us through your comp cards? Who have you got available? Who's here? Who's not here? Etc. And I think that just proves a point that I thought of 15 years ago, that it would infiltrate, that Real Women would infiltrate a media-driven, crazy world out there that where basically they think thin is in and that's the only way to be. But of course, I've proven differently. And it's obvious. You can now go on to any magazine, any manufacturer of clothing who in the past maybe only went up to size 16, now goes up to size 24. There were many, many times when I've sat at my desk and thought, what the hell am I doing this for? Why am I sitting here bashing my head against a brick wall when, you know, it just didn't seem like it was getting through? And then I remember one particular time I got this anonymous email. It just happened to come onto my desktop. And for the first time, it wasn't somebody wanting to be a model or asking me about, you know, industry driven. It was this young girl just saying to me in an email, I just love what you're doing. Keep doing it. And I thought, well, you know what? If I've touched one young girl to look back at her body and think that she could be a model, that she's okay to size 14, then that's what keeps me going. Formal training, yes. In actual fact, I'm just in the process of speaking with a company at the moment who are actually putting together a Certificate 3 course for models, which is about time. I do find Australian girls they're a little bit slack in a way they do approach the agency. You know, we are quite specific on photographs that we require, and we get lots of photographs with mobile phones in the back of a mirror and all this sort of stuff. It's very disheartening. If I have one thing to say, Australian girls really need to pick up their act in regards to the interview process. And, you know, when you arrive at an agency, not to have thongs on, to have, you know, clear nails and feet, to have good bra and underwear, because you will be requested to have a photograph taken in your bra and underwear because we're looking at body shape. So yes, look, I'm not saying formal training, but at least some inside knowledge. I describe myself as being larger than life, and my motto is basically, actually, carpe diem. I've actually got the dog tag on today, you know, which means seize the day, live each day like it's your last because you're a long time dead.